Sa video natin ngayon, we will discuss the Muller-Breslau principle in drawing the influence line diagram. So this is also called the qualitative method. Yan. In 1886 daw, Muller-Breslau developed a technique for rapidly constructing the shape of an influence line, which is referred to as the Muller-Breslau principle. Now, it states that the influence line for a function, reaction, shear, or moment, is to the same scale as the deflected shape of the beam when the beam is acted upon by the function. In order to draw the deflected shape properly, the capacity of the beam to resist the applied function must be removed, so the beam can deflect when the function is applied. So let's say we have a simply supported beam. Ayan. Now, if the shape of the influence line for the vertical reaction at A is to be determined, the pin is first replaced by a roller guide, and then a roller guide is necessary since the beam must resist a horizontal force at A but not a vertical force. Now, if we want to solve the reaction at A, lalagyan natin siya ng roller guide daw. So replace this with a roller guide and then allow the beam to deflect due to the vertical reaction at A. So ito yung mayayari. Yan. So we added a roller guide, yan, and then this is AY. And then we allowed the beam to deflect due to AY, kaya andito na siya. Yan, meron kasing roller dyan, single roller, napuntaan siya dito. So this would be the shape of our influence line. And then the ordinate at this point, at the location of the reaction, this would be equal to 1. Ayan. So ito na yung influence line natin. Essentially, this is just a triangle, which is the same lang din sa quantitative method or yung method na nag-table tayo. Gumawa tayo ng table of values. So again ha, the beam must resist a horizontal force at A but not a vertical force. That's why the vertical force induced a deflection. Sige, so another example naman. Let's say we have an overhanging beam and then we are to analyze the shear. If the shape of the influence line for the shear at C at this particular point is to be determined, the connection at C may be symbolized by a roller guide. So, ito yan. The device will resist a moment and axial force but not shear. Yan, kapag meron kang roller guide. Applying a positive shear force VC to the beam at C and allowing the beam to deflect to the dashed position, we find the influence line shape. So, at this part, yan, let's draw a roller guide para sa dalawang sides kasi merong dalawang sides ng shear, merong downward saka upward, 'di ba? Once mag-cut ka and then the internal forces are revealed. So ito 'yan. Ito yung roller guides natin. Silang dalawa. And then meron tayong positive shear. So downward yung maglalabasan diyan and then dito naman is upward. 'Yan to maintain internal equilibrium. So once andito na yung shear force natin, let's allow the beam to deflect. So try to imagine, if this is already na-cut na siya dyan, yan. If we will apply this particular load, the beam will deflect, di ba, downward. Therefore, this portion, yan, yung shape niya magiging ganito na. Yan. Kasi, nag-deflect siya downward at this point, so this will also move upward since rotation is allowed sa hinge support but deflection isn't. And then sa right side naman, if this is allowed to move up, yan, magiging ganito na siya, diba? Kasi merong roller support dyan, walang deflection na mangyayari. So once this deflects, yan, mag-move up lang to, yan. So, ito na siya. Sige, so, ito na yung deflected shape natin. Ayan. So, this is actually the shape of the beam once it's allowed to deflect. So, ito lang talaga yung concept dyan. And then, let's say, this is the hinge support. Ito naman yung roller. Ano yung value niyan? The value here would be negative A divided by L. And then dito naman, this ordinate would be B over L, where this is the distance A, yan, and then this is the distance B. And then, yung height dito, you can just obtain it by using ratio and proportion, since these are similar triangles, this one and this one. Sige, sa next example naman tayo. Now, what if we are to draw the influence line for the moment at C? Iba naman, di ba? Kanina, reaction saka shear. So, paano naman kapag moment? Kapag moment, an internal hinge or pin is placed at C. Kasi di ba, yung internal hinge, it resists axial and shear force, but it cannot resist moment, since it will be allowed to rotate. So, itong point C, gagawin natin siyang internal hinge. Ayan. Now, kapag internal hinge na yan, and then we will apply positive moments, ito yung positive moments natin. Diba, counterclockwise yung effect niya sa left side, and then sa right side, clockwise yung effect. Ayan. So, kapag i-apply natin yung rotations na yan, what happens is, this portion would deflect this way. Mag-rotate siya counterclockwise. So, magiging ganyan. Diba? And then, for this portion naman, if this will rotate clockwise, parang paganyan, so, magiging ganito na siya. Ayan. And then, yung values ng ordinates, the same lang sa tinuro kong shortcut. Doon sa first video natin, using the quantitative method. Yung sinali ko kasing shortcut, were derived using this method. Now again, magzi-zero yan siya sa supports. Since walang deflection dyan. Walang deflection na mangyayari. So our influence line for MC would be this one. So zero dito sa location ng supports. And then this ordinate would be AB divided by L, where this is A, ayan, and then this is B naman. Sige, next naman. Next, we have a fixed support. Now, kapag fixed support, let's say, we want the influence line for the reaction at A. Sabihin natin, AY. Now, ito yung dapat mong tandaan. Kung meron kang fixed support, tapos gusto mo yung reaction, then you need to add a double roller guide. This is because yung support na to, it will resist both a moment at the fixed support and an axial load, but hindi siya magre-resist ng vertical reaction. So ito yung itsura ng double roller guide. Ayan. So notice na yung double roller guide natin, merong roller dyan saka dito. Kailangan siya mag-resist ng moment kasi meron kasing moment reaction sa fixed support. So, mayayari dyan, once AY is applied, then this will just actually deflect upward continuously. So, the beam will remain horizontal, yan, but this will move up. So, meaning, this will deflect upward. Ito na yung ordinate ng influence line natin. So, this is AY. Ayan. Or simply, kapag maximum reaction, maximum ordinate sa support will only be 1. So, ito na yung deflected shape natin. And then, you can write this as 1. Positive 1. Sige, so, next naman. Let's say we have a fixed support. And then, we will draw the influence line for shear at this particular point, point B. So, ito yung mangyayari. Sa point B, let's add roller guides. Diba? Kasi yan yung gagawin natin kapag shear na influence line. So, add tayo ng roller guides and then maglalabasa na yung shear forces, internal forces. So, dito downward, and then dito naman, acting upward. Now, notice sa left side ng beam, sa left side ng roller guide natin, the beam is not allowed to rotate since merong fixed support. Ibig sabihin, walang deflected shape sa portion na to. Yan, walang deflected shape. And then yung magda-deflect lang would only be this portion. But take note na walang support sa point na to. So kapag walang support dyan and then this load is applied upward, then the beam will just continuously move up. So parang mag-move up siya, and then andito na yung location ng beam. Yan. So this would be the deflected shape. Now, bakit hindi same kanina na naging ganyan siya? Wait lang. Yan, 'di ba kanina ganto 'yan. Meron kasing roller support kanina sa simply supported na example natin. So, kaya this isn't allowed to deflect. But again, here this is a free end. So, mangyayari deflect lang 'yan siya upward. And then our influence line would be essentially parang constant line lang siya. So kapag i-draw natin 'yan, this would be our influence line. Yan, and then the value here is 1. Saka dito rin. Hindi na siya magiging A over L or B over L kasi hindi naman siya naging triangle. So no need na 'yan. Automatic na 'yan, 1. Parang reaction lang din. So this is the influence line for the shear at B. Now what if we have a cantilever beam or we have an overhanging beam and then we are to analyze the moment at the portion na nasa overhanging side. Ito yung mayayari. Yan, let's say we have this beam and then gusto natin yung moment sa point na to, yung influence line niya. If the shape of the influence line for moment at a point within a beam overhang or a cantilever beam is to be drawn, the deflected shape would be as follows. So this portion, again, diba sa moment, gagawin natin siyang internal hinge. So kapag internal hinge na yan siya, and then we will apply positive moments, yan, yan yung internal forces niya, then we would have this deflected shape. Now, bakit hindi siya umikot dyan? Bakit hindi siya naging ganyan? Meron kasing dalawang supports, diba? So kapag merong dalawang supports dyan, and then this is allowed to rotate counterclockwise, hindi kasi siya iikot kasi this is preventing movement and also this one. So kaya sa point na to, the beam will remain horizontal within this region. Yan. However, sa side na to, yan, mangyayari, if we are to apply a clockwise movement, then what happens is this will rotate clockwise. So magiging ganito na yung deflected shape. Oh, so ito na din yung moment natin. Ito na siya. And then the shortcut here will be the same sa binigay ko, yung portion na merong overhang for negative moment sa quantitative na video natin. Now ilalagay ko na lang din yung value. So sa value, ito yung gagawin natin. Just apply a unit load sa point na to, let's say 1. This is true ha kapag yung point natin is at an overhang. So just get the moment at this point if the unit load is placed at the free end. So let's say this distance is sabihin natin A. Yan, so this value, this would be the unit load multiplied by the distance A. Ito lang. And then this would be negative kasi negative moment 'yan sa overhang kapag downward yung load. So ito lang yung dapat mong tandaan. And then the same din kapag meron kang fixed support, the same lang yung gagawin natin. Ito lang siya. And then the computation of the maximum ordinate, the same lang din dito. Sige, so let's try to answer an example which is a past board exam problem. Yan. So we have the following beam and then we are given the highway uniform live load. These are moving loads And then we also have a concentrated live load of 46.75. So this is our beam configuration. So medyo may bago lang kasi merong internal hinge na sa actual beam. Hindi yan siya cost sa moment ha. Meron talagang internal hinge. Since this is what makes the beam determinate. Kasi for determinate structures, automatic yung influence line natin, straight line segments lahat. So kaya kailangan talaga na determinate siya. Sige, so meron tayong A, B, C, D, apat na points. And then first, we have the following question. What is the maximum upward reaction at A due to the uniformly distributed load? And B, what is the maximum downward reaction at A due to the uniformly distributed load? So mayayari dyan is we want the maximum reaction at A. Diba? So itong hinge support, let's replace it with a roller guide and then papalitan natin yung ito yung ginagawa ko, yung support pinapalitan ko ng vertical reaction. So let's say ito yung AY. Yan, so we replaced it with a vertical reaction and then let's allow the beam to deflect. Once this is applied, yan, it will move up, diba? So the beam will be parang ganito na. Ayan. Zero yung deflection dyan, kaya it will stay dito. And then, since meron tayong internal hinge, then, bababa yan. Bababa yan siya. And then, sa point D naman, yan, this will also move down. So, ito yung connecting line patungo sa D. And so, ito essentially yung deflected shape. Now, ipapakita ko na lang yung animation para ma-imagine nyo. So once this is applied, what happens to the beam is this. Ayan. So this would be the deflected shape na. So draw natin yung influence line. Ibalik natin siya. And then the ordinate here, since we want the reaction at A, this would move up. And then the ordinate is 1. And then again, diba, naging ganyan siya. So continue natin yung deflected shape. Ito. And then, going to D, bumalik siya sa point na to. So, ito yan. And then, we have an ordinate here sa point C, which we will label as Y. This one. To get this one, we can use ratio and proportion. So, by the way, i-separate ko na lang sa beam yung influence line natin. And move natin siya sa ilalim. So this would be 1. Ayan. And then the horizontal distance is D-bat 25. And then the horizontal distance here is 5. Which is this one. Then dito naman 15. Ayan. So to get Y, we can use ratio and proportion for this triangle. Ito yung titingnan natin na. This triangle and this triangle are similar. Diba? So, we can say that 1 is to 25 and then Y is to a distance of 5. Yan. So, sulat natin. And then solving Y, we get 0.2. So, this ordinate pala is 0.2. Ayan. So, first, we have to solve the maximum upward reaction at A due to the uniform load. Uniform load alone lang ha. Wala pang concentrated live load. So, for the positive reaction, maximum positive reaction, then we have to use the positive area din. Yan. And then, we will apply the load sa portion na to. So, apply natin yung load. We would have this one. Hanggang sa point na to, point B. Ayan. So this is 10 kilonewton per meter. This is for letter A. So multiply mo lang to, the uniform, kapag meron kang uniform load, multiply it sa area ng under the influence line diagram. So 10, multiply ko yan by the area of this triangle, makukuha ko yung maximum positive reaction. So the positive maximum reaction is 1/2 times base multiplied by the height, then multiplied by the uniform load. Ayan. So we get 125 kilonewtons. So yan yung positive reaction natin or upward reaction. Now how about for the negative reaction? For the negative reaction, we have to use this area. Yan. Since this is below the zero line, ibig sabihin, negative. So I would have negative reaction is 1/2 times base. Bakit 20? 20 since 15 plus 5 is 20. And then multiplied by a height of 0.2, yung nakuha natin kanina, then multiplied by the uniform load, 10. So we have 20 kilonewtons. Now what if meron tayong concentrated load? Kapag merong concentrated load, then you will just have to multiply this to the maximum ordinate. So for example, we want the maximum upward reaction at A. So dito mo lang ilalagay yung concentrated load. Lalagyan mo ng 46.75 kilonewtons. And then, let's say lang, included siya sa problem, then you will have to add dito sa positive Rmax, mag-plus tayo ng 46.75 multiplied by the maximum ordinate, which is 1. So, times 1. Ayan. So, yan lang yung basic na concept talaga. So, sa next question naman tayo. What length of the beam must be loaded with a uniformly distributed load to produce the maximum reaction at the support at D? So, ito yung support at D. Yan. So, para ma-draw natin yung influence line, papalitan natin siya ng vertical reaction dy. Ayan. So, this is already dy. And then, let's allow the beam to deflect. Now, since merong internal hinge dyan, yan, what would happen is this portion will remain horizontal while this one, this will deflect up. So parang ito. Yan, and then the beam will rotate pa ganyan. So itong part na to, this remains unbothered. Sige, so kapag idraw natin yung movement, ito yung mangyayari. Ayan. So once this load is applied, this will deflect upward. So this will be our influence line. Ayan. Ito lang, since this remains horizontal, tapos yung ordinate natin dito, this would be equal to 1. So therefore, the length of the beam that must be loaded with a uniform load to produce the maximum reaction would be this length. Ayan. So ano yung length na yan? Diba, this is 15 meters. Yan. So, ito lang. Ito lang yung sagot natin. So, next question naman. Compute the maximum reaction at the support at B due to the given loads. So, sinabi dito ha, due to the given loads. So, kailangan kasali yung highway uniform live load saka concentrated live load. So, ito lang yung nagbago essentially. So, for the maximum reaction at the support at B, papalitan natin to ng concentrated load due to the vertical reaction. So, tatanggilan natin yung roller support, papalitan natin ng force. Ayan. Then, once we apply this force, what happens to the beam is, since merong internal hinge dyan, then the beam will rotate pa ganyan. Kasi magde-deflect siya upward. Ayan. And then, this would be 1. So, meron din siyang ordinate dito. And then, from point D naman, yan, sabay kasi mag-move yung left and right portion. So, magiging ganito na siya. Pero straight line yan. Sige, so, ito yung movement niya pag idodraw natin talaga. Ayan. So, nag-move up siya. So this would be our influence line diagram. Ayan. So 1 yung ordinate directly below point B. But notice na the maximum ordinate will occur dito sa internal hinge. Kasi di ba nag-move kasi siya diyan. Andito yung maximum. Therefore, we would have to solve that. So this horizontal distance, this is 25 meters. Ayan. And then sulat na lang natin yung horizontal distances. Ayan. So 25, 5 saka 15. And then let's try to solve the ordinate at this point. Ayan, draw tayo ng vertical line. And then let's label this as y. Ayan. So if this is y, then we can use ratio and proportion using the whole triangle. Ayan, the whole triangle and this smaller triangle. Ayan. So we have 1:25 for the smaller triangle, and for the larger triangle we have y is to a distance of 30 meters. Yan, kasi 30 yung buong distance na yan. So 1:25 equals y over 30. Solving y, we get 1.2. So this would be 1.2 din. Ayan. And so solving the maximum reaction, then we have to place the loads. Diba? Due to the given loads, kailangan applied yung dalawa. So, you can apply it sa beam or dito na lang sa ilalim. So, I would have to apply the uniform live load sa buong span. Kasi lahat ng ordinates are positive. So, it would be safe to say na pwede mo siyang ilagay sa buong span talaga. For a while. So, ito yung uniform load natin. This is a straight line. Hindi ko lang siya na draw na straight. So this is 10 kilonewton per meter. Ayan. And then yung concentrated live load natin, ilalagay natin sa location ng maximum ordinate to induce the maximum reaction din. Ayan. So lalagyan ko ng 46.75 kilonewtons. So our maximum reaction would be 1/2 times 45 times 1.2 times 10. This is the area of the triangle. So 1/2 times base. 45 yan kasi 25 plus 5, 30 plus 15 magiging 45. And then the height of the triangle is 1.2. Ayan. Then multiplied by 10 dahil sa uniform load. And then for this one naman, this is the concentrated load, 46.75, multiplied by the maximum ordinate, which is 1.2. Ayan. Sige, so we have 326.1 kilonewtons. Now, kung gusto niyo talaga ma-demonstrate natin, try natin gamitin yung app natin. So, keep ko lang yan. And then dito tayo. So open natin yung diffraction light. So dito tayo. Remove ko to lahat. And then the span of the beam is, check ko lang ah. This is, diba, 45. So 45. Ayan. And then we have a support sa both ends. Lagyan natin ng simple support. And then pwede rin na di ba meron tayong ruler. Dito meron tayong ruler diyan. Wait lang, check natin yung original beam. Ito pala. So at point B and also at point D. So let's add a vertical ruler. Ito siya. Ito yung symbol niya. Saka sa ano rin, point B, which is 25 meters from the left. So 25. Ayan. And then we have an internal hinge located 30 meters from A. So ito lang. And then click this one. ito yung internal hinge. So this would be 30. So ito na yung beam natin, and then try natin kunin yung 326.1. So to get this maximum reaction at support B, then we would have to apply the uniform load over the whole span. So lagyan natin. Ayan. Diba, this is 10 kilonewton per meter. So ito na yung reactions niya. And then we also have to place 46.75 at the location of the internal hinge. So ito yung internal hinge, diba? At 30 meters. So lalagyan ko siya ng 46.75. Yan. Notice that the reaction at anong tawag dito? At the reaction at B is already 326.1. Which is the same sa nakuha natin. Diba? 326.1. Now, if you'll move this anywhere, let's say dito, notice na mag-iiba yung reaction. It will be lesser, 298. And then, let's say dito, malapit sa internal hinge, we would have a reaction of 322. But the maximum is 326.1 kasi yan yung location ng maximum ordinate. Yan yung concept dyan. And then, try natin to. What length of the beam must be loaded with a uniformly distributed load to produce the maximum reaction at the support at D? So, ito yung support at D. Diba? So, tatanggalin ko to. And then, to produce the maximum reaction at this particular support, yan. Diba, this is 75 when the beam is loaded over the entire span. But yung nasolve natin dito is only 15 meters from C to D lang yung point of application ng load. So what if imo-move ko to sa hanggang sa internal hinge lang. So this would be 15. Notice that we still have 75. Diba? The same lang yan kahit ilagay mo siya sa buong span. 75 pa rin. Kasi zero yung ordinates dito. And wala silang effect sa reaction at D. Only this one talaga. Yan, yung 15 meters na span. So, pwede lang talaga na ito lang yung i-load mo. You can already produce the maximum reaction na. Ayan. O, 75 lang din. So, sa ano naman? Sa first question, ito. Diba, meron tayong positive maximum reaction. We also have a negative maximum reaction. So, try natin i-apply yung uniform load from A to B. Diba? Kasi yan yung positive natin kanina. Positive maximum reaction. So, from A to B, we have a distance of 25. So, 25 yan. And then notice, the reaction, sana yan? The reaction at A is 125. Ito. Once imu-move natin siya slightly to the right, bababa yung value niya. Bakit 123.542? Kasi negative na kasi yung ordinate dyan. So once imu-move mo siya sa portion na to, mababawasan yung reaction at A. Ayan. And then for the maximum downward reaction naman, we would have to place the uniform load from B to D. So this is 25, and then ito na siya. So notice the reaction at A is already downward, diba? Negative 20 kasi yung nakuha natin kanina for the negative maximum reaction. Now once i-move ko siya slightly to the right, the reaction here will also reduce. And then kapag i-move ko siya slightly to the left of point B, then magiging 80 na siya. So, the maximum reaction will be induced kapag andito talaga siya sa 25 meters. Yan. So, magiging 20 siya. Downward. Yan. Downward. So, yan lang yung concept talaga ng influence line. It defines the reactions, shear, and moment whenever a unit load is placed anywhere along the span so that you can apply it para sa moving loads. Mas madali na siyang ma-identify. lalo na kapag meron kang mga critical points. Sige, so I believe ito lang. And then take note na there are some cases na ibibigay yung beam weight. For example, highway uniform live load, concentrated live load, and then let's say na merong dead load. Let's say beam weight dead load is equal to 10 wait lang, sabihin lang natin 2 kilonewton per meter. Ayan. So kapag meron kang beam weight or dead load, 'di ba? Yung dead load mag-a-act talaga 'yan sa buong span regardless of the ordinates here. Yan, so mangyayari diyan, just apply another dead load. For example, you want the maximum upward reaction at A due to the uniformly distributed load. And let's say and dead load. Ayan. What is the maximum upward reaction considering the uniform live distributed load and dead load? So you'll have to apply the dead load over the whole span. Lalagyan mo yan ng 2. So ito rin 2. Ayan. Whole span, kasi yung dead load, again, sa buong span talaga yan siya. Hindi siya mag-change. Hindi kasi siya live load. So, the maximum reaction at A, upward reaction pala yan. So, ito lang. Dito natin i-apply yung load pala. Move ko lang to. This would be 25. Ayan. Palitan ko na lang yung value ha, para hindi kayo malito. 20 kasi yan kanina. Gagawin ko na lang tong 0.5. Mas maliit na lang. Para makita nyo talaga. Ito yung ginawa dyan. We have 10 kilonewton per meter. And then, we also have to add the dead load over the whole span. Ayan. So, this is equivalent to 0.5 kilonewton per meter. Ayan. So, our solution for the maximum reaction at A, so this would be RA, this would be equal to 10, yung area na lang, 1 half times base. Base na 25, and then height is 1. Then multiplied by 10. And then plus 1 half times base. Ito muna, sa positive muna. Yung base is 25, the height is 1. Ayan. And then this is to be multiplied by 0.5. Or pwede rin na sa portion na to, i-add mo na lang yung loads. Bale, 10 plus 0.5 magiging 10.5 na. Or yan na lang yung gagawin ko. Yan, sa positive na part. So, 1 half times 25 times 1 times 10.5 due to the combination of the dead load and the live load. And then sa portion na to, from B to D, we would have a negative area. Yan, so minus 1 half times, ano yung base? The base is 20. So lalagyan ko ng 20. And then the height is 0.2. Essentially, the same lang dito. Tapos, multiply ko by 0.5. 0.5 lang kasi from B to D, only the dead load is acting. Sige, so input daw natin sa calculators. 0.5 times 25 times 1 times 10.5 and then minus 1 half times 20 times 0.2 multiplied by 0.5 equals, ano yan? 130.25. Teka na, ba't iba siya dito? Baka naglalag siya. Ayan, naglalag pala siya. 20, hindi siya nag-change. Wait lang ha. Restart ko na lang yung app. Ito kasi dapat yung sagot natin. Kailangan, yung nakuha natin is 130.25. Lagay ko na lang ah. Ayan. So this is including the dead load or beam weight. Ayan. Now, model ko na lang ulit. So merong support dyan. And then 10 kilonewton per meter from A to B only. Yan, kasi live load yan. This is 25. Ayan. And then we have to add a dead load sa buong span. So this is 0.5. Saka ito rin. And then meron pala tayong internal hinge. Sorry, hindi ko nalagay. Internal hinge at 30 meters. Ayan. So notice, the reaction here is already 130.25. Ayan. The same lang. Kapag meron ng beam weight. Kasi again, beam weight, applied yan over the whole span. Regardless of the question. Ayan. Magbabago lang siya kapag live load. Sige. I think yan lang talaga yung mga possible na lalabas. So I hope may natutunan kayo ngayon. And then if you want to practice some problems, just use the app. And then try to make your own questions for the possible na lalabas sa time nyo. Sige, sige.